before you know that the customer makes up their mind of which product they want to buy, they've already gone through maybe you know that maybe 12 to 15 different phases of the journey. And it's better that you know how we can associate in the beginning rather at the end that was already has made up their mind. So how important do you feel the organization or the marketing leader should empower their employees to face the failure, and so that you know they can think beyond and they don't get stuck to the tried and tested method, because that is not going to work nowadays. Is right? It's completely digital. Digitally, as you mentioned, it's completely crowded. You can't just apply what you know worked maybe 5 years back. So marketing leaders, they are playing a play a very, very critical role, you know, in this space. So what's your, you know, point of view?
I think, yeah, absolutely. I think there's something that we could learn from the way the startups operate. I engage with a lot of startups and I get a lot of opportunity to learn from them. I think it's not about the fear of failure. It's about failing smart, right? And I think that's the word. And today, if you compare the world is digital now, right? And that's, there are the tools available. Compare it with, okay, let's look at cameras, you know. Mm-hmm. There was a time when you have to have those reels and failing in those and having not the right shot. I do a bit of photography and started with that Yashica camera, which used to have a reel, you know, and it was very expensive to make mistakes with that, right? But today you can take 100 shots and figure out, okay, which are the 10 best out of it, which you could really take out. So I think that's the amount of testing that you can do about with your messaging, the A-B testing. I think that's the cost of failure has drastically come down now. And there's you could get quick responses. And I think it's about feeling smart, ability to do as many tests, small tests as possible, get your messaging right, and then really scaling it out and investing heavily in what you think is working for your customers. So I think the world has shifted and it's to the advantage of the marketers. It's unfortunate that some of our marketers are still, you know, we are bounding ourselves with our traditional mindsets and unable to leverage what is available.
Exactly. Completely agree. So, you know, failing smart, okay, you know, that's, now the failing smart, so can you give some, you know, real life experience that you face? Like one of your campaign that you wish that, you know, done really, you know, that well. But if you want to redo that, you know, engagement altogether, so what are the, you know, changes that you, you know, that you would have brought into this overall?
I think I would possibly do that in the early years of as a marketer when I was, and I got in. And, you know, there were a lot of campaigns that I was running. I was obviously engagement, but there again, I was I realized, which is the mistake a lot of you know young marketers do make, is where do you place yourself in the whole business, right? And if you're placing yourself just responsible for generating leads for sales, that's where you get it wrong most of the time. And that's what I actually did, was possibly was the sole purpose as a marketer when I started, and that's where there was some bit of a dissonance between the business and the marketing function that I used to lead. But at that point of time, I thought it was that I am doing absolutely the right things which the marketer is supposed to do. So I think that's the, you know, I would probably go back and change a lot there, the way I used to operate earlier. And I think that's, and then that's the place I think I would say. I would not have wanted to, I would probably used to invest a lot in tele, rather than actually, because it was all about lead generation, getting the pipeline, looking at the, you know, so we get, you make not your customer, but your metric that you kind of operate on, your North Star, and that's where you start getting it wrong overall. So I think that those are some of the mistakes I made. I'd like to go back and redo them again if I get an opportunity.